Hello students, a very good afternoon to all of you. Yesterday I completed the explanation of lesson number 10, the sermon at Benares. Today we will discuss the question answers of this lesson. Yesterday I also gave you 5 short questions to do. I hope you all must have done that work. I am giving here the answers to those questions. You can tally and judge yourself whether you have attempted up to the mark accurately or not. Your first question was, who are called mortals? Its answer is, human beings are called mortals. Question number 2, mortals have been compared to 2 things. What are they? While explaining, I have told you that mortals are compared with 2 things. The answer to this question is ripe fruits and earthen vessels. Question number 3, in what way are mortals like ripe fruits? Its answer is, as ripe fruits have the danger of falling, in the same manner, in the same way, mortals are always in fear of death, in danger of death. Question number 4, how is the fate of human beings similar to earthen vessels? Here you can write, as all earthen vessels end in being broken, so is the life of mortals, so is the life of human beings. All human beings are subject to death. Question number 5, what is the most powerful thing according to the Buddha? The most powerful thing according to the Buddha is the power of death. No one can escape. So this is the most powerful, the power of death. Now we come to the question answers, page number 135. Thinking about the text, here your first question is, when her son dies, Kisa Gotami goes from house to house. What does she ask for? Does she get? Why not? So the question is in parts. While answering, be careful that you may have to give answers to all the parts. After the death of her only son, Kisa Gotami was overcome with grief. She was very sad. She carried the dead body of her son in her arms and goes from house to house asking for medicine to cure her son. Then it is asked, does she get it? You have to give its answer. She does not get the medicine. Here we are talking first time. Why? Because her son was dead and there is no such medicine available which can bring a dead person back to life. So she was not able to get the medicine from any of the houses. Question number 2, Kisa Gotami again goes from house to house. This is the second time. After meeting Buddha, again she goes. Kisa Gotami again goes from house to house after she speaks with the Buddha. What does she ask for? The second time around, does she get it? Why not? First time she was asking for the medicine. Now the question is, second time what she was asking for, does she get or not? We have to give its answer. Its answer is, after speaking with the Buddha, Kisa Gotami goes from house to house and asks the people to give her mustard seed. Gautam Buddha asks her to bring seeds from the house where death had never knocked. Second part was, does she get it? Its answer is, no, she does not get it. Why? Because she could not find a single house where death had not taken a beloved away. Question number 3. What does Kisa Gautami understand the second time that she failed to understand the first time? Was this what the Buddha wanted her to understand? So its answer is, first time Kisa Gautami failed to understand that death was inevitable. It comes to each and every one. She was not able to understand this. Second time, she understood death is inevitable and common to all, and she was being selfish in her own grief. Then, was this what Buddha wanted her to understand? Yes, this is what Buddha wanted her to understand, that everyone who is born has to definitely die. One day or the other, sooner or later. One should not grieve over death. Question number 4. Why do you think Kisa Gautami understood this only the second time? She was not able to understand first time. Second time she understood. In what way did the Buddha change her understanding? You have to write in its answer, Kisa Gautami understood this only the second time because the people she visited for mustard seeds, she was asking for mustard seeds, told her that everyone was dealing with the loss of a beloved one. Everyone have experienced the death of their loved ones. Gautam Buddha, second part, Gautam Buddha told her to bring a handful of mustard seeds from a house where death had never knocked at, where death had never taken place. This way, she got aware that death is common. When she did not get the mustard seeds, she did not found such house, what she realized, that death is inevitable. It brought a change in her attitude towards death. Question number 5. How do you usually understand the idea of selfishness? Do you agree with Kisa Gautami that she was being selfish in her grief? Again, 2 parts. How do you usually understand the idea of selfishness? We understand the idea of selfishness how? As a concern for one's own self. Then, as a concern for one's own self, you can also write, a selfish person is one who only thinks about himself or herself. Second part, do you agree with Kisa Gautami that she was being selfish in her grief? Yes, we agree with Kisa Gautami when she says that she was being selfish in her grief as she was thinking of her own sorrow. She was thinking of her own son's death. She did not realize at that time that all suffer because of death. So these were the questions of this lesson. The lesson gives us a message. Life and death are the process of life. Nobody can escape death. We must not grieve over the death. Only those who overcome sorrow get peace. We must give up grieving, complaining, lamentation. Weeping is no solution to sorrow. So write the answers of these questions in your notebook books. Learn them also. Thank you. Have a nice day.